workers movement, a journalist of outstanding capacity, and above all, a writer beyond his writings. Yes, he was a writer far beyond his writings. He never confined himself within the modest limits of his writings. He traveled far beyond. He was not a spectator. He was a partaker. He was a nationalist to the core, a freedom fighter, a social reformer, active in the field, liberating man and society from eternal bondages. His vision went beyond India, and the world itself was a conditioned, restricted canvas for his pen. He is one of the greatest sons of India, on whom she can rightly be proud of. He was born at Ettayapuram in Tirunelveli district, Tamil Nadu, to Sri Chinnasamy Iyer and Lakshmi Ammal. It was 50 years after Rajaram Mohan Roy left the Indian scene. It was 58 years after the birth of Dayananda Saraswati. It was 46 years after the arrival of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. It was 25 years after the First War of Independence, stigmatized as Sipai mutiny by the English historian. It was 8 years after the close of Ramalinga Swami's spiritual life. In 1882, the year of our poet's birth, Bankim Chandra Chatterjee's patriotic writings have reached their zenith. As he was three, Indian National Congress came to be organized, Chinnasamy Iyer urged his son to the rigors of education. In his versified autobiography, the poet weeps his lungs out how, when boys of his age could spend their time in play and gay abandon, as his father insisted more on skill in mathematics, he was absorbed in nature, the rhythmic pattern he was at ease with. When the assembly of scholars at Ettayapuram honored him, the child prodigy was just 11 years old. In 1897, Bharathi married Chellammal, who was 7 years old. Bharathi was 15 years then. His love songs are immortal wings of eternal light. They have a freshness of this morning roses.
கண்ணம்மா நின்றன் காதலை எண்ணி கழிக்கின்றேன் அமுதூற்றினையொத்த இதழ்களும் நில ஊரித்ததும் கும்பிழிகளும் அமுதூற்றினையொத்த இதழ்களும் நில ஊரித்ததும் கும்பிழிகளும் பத்து மாற்று பொன்னொத்த நின்மேனியும் இந்த வையத்தில் யான் உள்ள மட்டிலும் பத்து மாற்று பொன்னொத்த நின்மேனியும் இந்த வையத்தில் யான் உள்ள மட்டிலும் என்னை வேற்று நினைவின்றி தேற்றியே இங்கோர் விண்ணவனாக புரியுமே ஆற்று வெளியீடை கண்ணம்மா நின்றன் காதலை எண்ணி கழிக்கின்ற
After the death of his father, Bharathi moved to Benares to be with his aunt. The 2 years he spent in Benares brought a great change in his outer personality and inner vision. He gained a sound knowledge of Sanskrit, Hindi, and English. Subramanya Bharathi could not stand the slothful, unconscious Indian society exploited to the pith and marrow by the British. Meek and submissive, inherited from the social oppression of centuries, Indians of his times were men in bondage. total and complete. Bharati, enraged at the criminal slur on the face of our motherland, came forward to remind the people of India of the glory of their motherland. Unity was of paramount importance to him. He was convinced that India, which was a divided house, was a fertile ground for foreign wheat. Hence he called for the unification of all Indians, burying fathoms deep the different castes, creeds, faiths and shades of opinion, sectarian in nature, working at cross purposes, eating the very vitals of our national fabric. He met Mahatma Gandhi while he was in Madras in the year 1920 and blessed his non-cooperation movement. He sang in praise of Mahatma, his national leadership anointed in the spiritual fragrance. He sang in ecstasy the life and message of Lokamanya Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai, Sister Nivedita, and V.O. Chidambaram Pillai. He was principally responsible for reviving the memories of Chhatrapati Shivaji among Tamils. His compositions aiming at national integration while the freedom of India was still a dream or prophetic, poetic utterances of a master mind. In his sweeping but deeply conscious canopy, he links the various parts of our motherland. His immortal songs on our motherland, in all her traits and streaks, in all her color and shades, are of eternal value. His national poems are his heart's throbs, his soul's unctions, unending varieties of fiery florals.
Thank you.
வாழ்ந்து போயின நாட்களுக்கினி மனம் நாணி கொல்லை இகழ்ச்சிகள் தீர இந்த கொண்டு நிலைமையில் பூ என்று தள்ளி வந்தே மாதரம் என்போம் எங்கள் மாநில தாயை வணங்கினும் என்போம் வந்தே மாதரம் என்போம் எங்கள் மாநில தாயை வணங்கினும் என்போம் வந்தே மாதரம் என்போம் வந்தே மாதரம் வந்தே
As a journalist of the first order, his editorials in Sudeshamitran were a class by themselves, wherein he made a fervent plea for the freedom of our motherland. His Tamil prose was simple, direct, and forthright. Though he is known for his powerful songs with new message, a new diction, his prose was more refined and cultivated from that of previous centuries. And Tamil prose came to be directed for the first time in a vigorous way, rousing the people for national liberation. It is no surprise that he suggested a far-reaching change in education. He suggested to prescribe the liberation histories of different lands and people, only to have methodical attack on the British enslavement. Freedom. Freedom. What for? This question was uppermost in his mind, and he was one of the few thinkers who were sure that India was politically and economically enslaved by the British because she was already in an internal siege of social oppression and cultural degeneration. In this clarity of vision, he was strikingly different from the rest of others. Only an egalitarian society where men and women are free from want and misery, freedom would be meaningful. Towards this end, he started his tireless work, uncompromising with expediencies of the passing phase. He was a matchless orator in English and Tamil. His meetings were largely attended. He was a foremost speaker and celestial singer who transported the magical hold into the slogan, Vande Mataram. Only a visionary of Subramania Bharati's magnitude could have thought of a democratic, socialistic society when our freedom was still far away from realization.
Bharata samudayam vaalgave, vaalga vaalga, Bharata samudayam vaalgave. ஜய 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 பாரத சமுதாயம் வாழ்கவே வாழ்க வாழ்க பாரத சமுதாயம் வாழ்கவே ஜய 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 பாரத சமுதாயம் வாழ்கவே மனிதர் உணவை மனிதர் பறிக்கும் வழக்கம் இனியுண்டு மனிதர் மோக மனிதர் பார்க்கும் வாழ்க்கை இனியுண்டோ மனிதர் உணவை மனிதர் பறிக்கும் வழக்கம் இனியுண்டோ மனிதர் மோக மனிதர் பார்க்கும் வாழ்க்கை இனியுண்டோ புலனில் வாழ்க்கை இனியுண்டோ நம்மில் அந்த வாழ்க்கை இனியுண்டோ பாரத சமுதாயம் வாழ்கவே வாழ்க வாழ்க பாரத சமுதாயம் வாழ்கவே ஜய 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 பாரத சமுதாயம் வாழ்கவே இனிய பொழில்கள் நெடிய வயல்கள் எண்ணரும் பெரும் நாடு கனியும் கிழங்கும் தானியங்களும் கணக்கின்றி தரும் நாடு இனிய பொழில்கள் நெடிய வயல்கள் எண்ணரும் பெரும் நாடு கனியும் கிழங்கும் தானியங்களும் கணக்கின்றி தரும் நாடு இது கணக்கின்றி தரும் நாடு நம் நித்தம் கணக்கின்றி தரும் நாடு பாரத சமுதாயம் வாழ்கவே வாழ்க வாழ்க பாரத சமுதாயம் வாழ்கவே ஜய 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 பாரத சமுதாயம் வாழ்கவே இனி
எல்லோரும் அமரநிலை எய்தும் நன்முறையை இந்தியா உலகிற்கு அளிக்கும் ஆம் இந்தியா உலகிற்கு அளிக்கும் ஆம் ஆம் இந்தியா உலகிற்கு அளிக்கும்
As long as women are kept in bondage, no nation would be free in the real sense. Hence, freedom of women for Subramania Bharati was a basic foundation for the independence of our motherland. In his immortal songs, he places women in an elevated plane as objects of worship and declares they are equal and rightful partners to men. It was his strong conviction that women are endowed with innate wisdom at their birth, and the world, however, tries to mar their acquired knowledge, still they would retain their native wisdom supreme. His petition to the Lord is an universal prayer transcending all religions, and his poetic diction has the inborn knack of all embracing illumination. He was a believer, and his submission, nay, total surrender to God in Vaishnavatic tradition shows him how he was above the clannish grooves of orthodoxy. Stay at Pondicherry, a French settlement, to further the cause of India's freedom brought him closer to Sri Aurobindo. Bharati once again delved deep into the eternal fountains of Vedas and Upanishads, and his spiritual vision further extended its frontiers. He approached God through his Vedantic search, and his philosophic voyage further broadened his outlook of society, society not in parts and particles, but as a whole and in full. Though he was a radical in his nationalistic outlook, The Vedantic philosophy made it feasible for him to retain the element of nationalism along with universal love. His devotional songs on the different bhavas of Lord Krishna in the great mystical Indian tradition speaks volumes for his capacity to assimilate and communicate. His love for children was abundant, and his Vedantic perception comes home even to small children. His songs are household occurrences wherever Tamil is understood today. Nationalism springs from the solid ground of his love for his native Tamil language and literature. He strives for his enriching Tamil idiom. though he was well versed in Sanskrit, Hindi and English, and a regular contributor to English papers like Madras Mail, Commonweal and Arya, his equal love for all the Indian languages are praiseworthy. Let us see what he has written in New India on March 5th, 1915. I feel it is high time to remind all parties concerned in discussions like this that most of the Indian languages have great historic and living literatures. Of course, their lustre has been slightly dimmed by economic conditions during these later days. The English-educated minority can be pardoned for being frightfully ignorant of the higher phases of our national literatures, but they will do well to drop that annoying attitude of patronage and condescension when writing and talking about a language. The Tamil language, for instance, has a living, philosophical and poetical literature that is far grander to my mind than that of the vernacular of England.
ஆத்திசோடி இளம்பிரையணிந்து மோனத்திற்கு முழுவன் மேனியார் ஆத்திசோடி இளம்பிரையணிந்து மோனத்திற்கு முழுவன் மேனியார் கருநிறங்கொண்டு பார்க்கடல் மிசை கிடப்போம் கருநிறங்கொண்டு கடல் மீசை கிடப்போம் தந்தை என பல மதத்தினர் உருவகத்தாலே உணர்ந்து உணராதே பல வகையாக பரவிடும் பரம்பொருள் ஒன்றே மகமதி நபிக்கு மறையருள்
Bharati's glorious life dedicated to nation came to an abrupt end on September 11th, 1921. In the short span of 39 years, Bharati's impression was not only a torch and searchlight into our darkest hours, but continues to guide us to our destiny. Subramanya Bharati's concern was not only for India, but for the whole humanity, as it is revealed in his eloquent songs on Soviet Revolution and on Belgium. He was one with Mazzini in his message for the youth of Italy. He lived his poetic vision. He was a writer beyond his writings, and his observations have eternal relevance to India and the world. Since they shrug off gently the temporary values of a passing phase, as he himself once triumphantly declared, his victory over death and decay has become an inseparable part of human history.